Okay, hello, welcome back to the channel. Today we have an original Nintendo 3DS. I'm presuming it's faulty and I'm presuming it's American because I appear to have written this on there before. If we look on the back, it does say Euro, so I presume I took the English board or the European board out of this, put it in a working USA console and stuck the working USA board in here because it needed to get sold. So, and I couldn't be bothered to fix it at the time, I presume. So let's get this apart. The sticker on the top says faulty top LCD. So we're going to strip it down, replace that LCD, and then we're going to install custom firmware on it. With any luck. So let's get it all to bits. I've spent most of the week fixing up DS lights. So this should be a welcome form of respite from that. One up top here. Make sure there's no memory card, and yep, off that comes. Hopefully those are working. We'll find out later. Once it's been disassembled and tinkered with. I mean, I've not plugged the lower screen in, so I'm going to do that first. You'd think they'd soldered these down or something, and that I could probably heat the iron up, but we'll take it off like that. So yeah, we'll have these two screws out, and this little bracket, and then these in and see what happens. This has just been sat on a shelf for at least 18 months, maybe 2 years. So now's as good a time as any to try and get it to go. So we power on, blue light, and yeah, straight off. And if you can see, yeah, well, it was worth a look. Before we take that out, this off. Get these little rubber grommets out. These are supposed to stop the top screen touching here when you close it, but they don't work, and you'll often find with this you get little lines here and little lines here where they meet there and there, and it just over time leaves a mark on there. But it's fine, we're going to replace this entirely with a brand new one. If I don't stab myself first. Peeled off, it's very well stuck down, or stuck down very well. Should lift off there easy enough. Come on, you've had six screws out. There we go. Don't want to lose that. Now for my first trick, I'm not going to do anything smart at all. Board out. Ah, top screen's not plugged in at all. Okay, right. Chuck the Wi-Fi card back on, and then we'll put all of these cables in. So that board was just sat in there. Camera cable back in, and the ever so squashed volume and 3D cable. It won't work without that, so I really hope that's not mullered. I've got spares, but they're not cheap. I think they're about £7 or £8 each. I mean, it's cheap, but it's not when you've got one of those and a screen. And these don't sell for a huge amount if they're import machines. Yeah. Oh, well, right. So we know something is up with it. Move the board out of the way. I could have just taped those down. Oh well. They can go over there, little DS bits. But you ought to come out. Come on. Out you get. Oh. Yeah, see, I'll just turn it upside down, it'll fall out. And then pop out the diffuser. Then we want to poke the hinge through like that. Yep, and we can remove this. Hopefully get those out of there, yep, lovely, right. That one there. Now, just to see if this is salvageable, we'll unpin those. There you come. There's my new screen. When I say new screen, I mean one that was laying in a box. So I'm going to try this one. If that doesn't work, we'll try this one. Oops. So you can go in there. You can go on there. Don't need to worry about the camera really, as it should turn on without the camera attached. It'll only throw up an error once you go to try and use the camera. And it will give a power off, please, and consult your manual error. Oh, this is not good. Right, that's in. Power light comes on. So yeah, we have some life, but obviously everything's in bits at the minute. So let's get it together, literally. That's the one we don't want. Where have the scissors gone? Oh, for God's sake. My cleaner's been at it again, tidying things away. Oh, hang on, I haven't got a cleaner. It's just me. Oh. We'll do it the hard way. I was just going to cut that off. I still am. Cut that off. Pop these out. Mm-hmm. And that should, lovely, just get out the way. Now, this one needs to curl up. And I should be able to get this one in without having to take all the others out. Should. You back over here. It's not really enough on that. I want a bit more. Go on, work, I dare you. I think I've bodged that into being broken. We'll find out in a sec. Put these back. Like this needs to unroll. Just there we go. And then this can just, I don't know, get out of the bloody way. There we go. Right, that's better. I think. You need to flip our. I'm going to put it back in here just for the strength sake of it, rather than trying to hold the ribbons and push buttons and potentially break something. I mean, I might have already broken something, but you know, it's Saturday morning. What else is there to do? Hinges in, lovely. I I'm not going to fully rebuild it until I know it is working. And I'll get this camera in now, because the last thing I want to do is get it all together and then find out that the camera's ruined as well. But I'm still sceptical about that ribbon. Should have just put a new one in. Right, we're on. We're off. Great. So after all that, it could have been this ribbon and not the top screen, but I don't think it was. That's flattened out a bit better, but I think it's had it. No, oh well. Okay, so that didn't work, really go to plan, did it? Let's get a fresh one of these. Now if this works, the screen is fine and I'll have to replace this. If it doesn't, that screen's wonky. Oh, warm my hands up. It's a bit cold in here today. So anyway, we'll take that one out. We'll start by putting these in. There's one. Hurrah. Two. Get in. Right. Now to jimmy this in. and cross some fingers. Yep, that turns on. Happy days. Right. Well, I suppose one, we'd better get the touch screen in. That went in much easier that time. Two, take these out. Hang on. Back in. Let's touch that, test that camera. Now that the touch screen is in. I'm not taking this top hinge off again for a third time. Twice will be enough, I think. On. Yada, yada, yada. Camera. Okay. I know, there's no SD card. Back screen, yep. Internal. Yep. Right, good. So it's functional. If not, put together. So you out of the way. Let's get the soldering iron on because that's going to need to be on now. Camera's good. So this one gets to go now. Mustn't throw that out though, because I need the speakers from it. I hate doing this. It's so fiddly. Stupid thing. Right, out it comes. If anyone knows an easy way to do this, please write it in the comments, because I don't. And it is infuriating. Let's try putting this one through. On its own. So I want to make it small as possible. Rolled up nicely and just poke it through. And then maybe, just maybe, the other two, which aren't too much hassle, can go in like that. By Jove, I think he's got it. Maybe. We'll see how it goes. I could have just knackered up all the ribbons. Again. There you go. Excuse me. I hope that's not the start of COVID. Christ. That's it, get round there. In there. Yep. Right. Let's see what it does. If it works, great. We will transplant the speakers across and get it back together. If it doesn't, I'm going to, I don't know, be grumpy. There we are. Those are now at an acceptable way. Yep, jolly good. Board, that's what I'm looking for, and what I am of changing epoxy screens about and ribbon cables, whatnot. Right, now you bet bloody work. Hoorah. Right. I'm not really keen on that. On the top screen. Hey ho, I'll have to clean that off later. Right, where are we? We're here. Soldering iron's gone to sleep, it's been that long. Right, Mesh Money Penny, it's time for speakers. Nice that they come pre-tinned. The 3DS XL ones don't. Or at least the last batch I bought didn't. So, yep, that's you in there. Got quite warm under there. Pillock. Right. Burnt me finger. Oh no. Right. This time we've got red on this side. Yep. And then black on that side. You are not supposed to be stuck to that magnet. Thank you very much. Needs to go in here, so we'll slide that in, fold it down here, and then make a nice bend in the cable there. And it'll just pop out because it wants to be an arsehole. Can't quite reach the sellotape. Now stop pinging out. So we put this back in here. Close that up for a sec. And we'll have the lid on. I'll do the screen screws up later. To get this back in place. Anyone see what I forgot to put in on the top screen? Yeah. The slider. And it's for reasons of me being an idiot like that, forgetting to do things. What if those screws are not in yet? Has to volume back in. Microphone needs to go in there and stay in there. Got four more screws for the board, which is in the right place. And when I say four more screws, I mean three more, because a second ago there were four and now I've lost one. I found it. Hadn't exactly gone far away, had it? So, by all rights, what we should have is a working USA 3DS console. And we'll find out in a minute. Just get these L and R buttons reattached. We'll just have a couple of screws in the back for the time being. That should be enough for that, so I can get the battery back in, power on, does this stupid green line come off? Yep, lovely. I can't turn the 3D effect down because slider is in here. There's your slider. Excellent. System settings. Is it going to say you in the corner? Yes, so it's definitely an American system. It's on 1113. I'm going to update this to the latest firmware and I shall be back. Right, we're updated. Latest firmware. Let's chuck some screws back in, give the screen a wipe down, get a new lens fitted to it, and then bang some custom firmware on here. Because at the moment, you put a DS game in, it comes up just fine. We'll pop a 3DS game in, and it's blank. Because it's a PAL region Cubic Ninja. What we aim to do is install custom firmware so that it will then be able to read cartridges from anywhere it damn well likes. Power that off, because I'm going to need the power off, and also I want this screen to be as clean as possible. Yep. Nice, fresh, new plastic lens over the top. Look at that, lovely. These little rubber grommets in. Get my fat fingerprints all over it already. Fortunately, there is a cover over that anyway, so. Let's get the rest of these screws in. So that is now nicely fixed. So I'm going to need a memory card, this little contraption here, which is a magnet, and a DS flash card. I'll tape that to about there. Insert this. Insert this. Now, I need to hold select, start, X, and power. And hopefully, once I peel this magnet away, well, no, it just doesn't do anything. I've managed to black screen of death it. Let's turn it on. I have actually killed it. All that effort, and I've broke it. Hold the power button down. Yep. Power on. So it does power up still. Where's the yeah. Power off. Stick that to there. power right off. I'm not sure I can actually kill the power while it's in sleep mode. Oh. Yeah, create the home menu. Go on. Hello, mate. You all right? There we go. Left, down, right, up, A. Can remove that now. So now we want to turn this off because it's got that on it. Superb. I'm going to pop the memory card back out, switch some files around. And now that we've swapped those files around on the SD card, we'll pop that in. Power it back up. And it won't do anything because I've obviously put the wrong files on. No. Could not detect an SD card. What do you mean you can't detect an SD card? Data management. See, there's an SD card. Power off. Thank you. Once you've gone off, menu, script, mega script, description Pilex guide, setup Luma, yeah. Down, right, left, down, A. Lovely. Clean up the SD card. Start to reboot. And as if by magic, we're going to pop Cubic Ninja in. And there it is. Little Cubic Ninja in all his glory. Ugh, Ubisoft. Excellent. Well, that's that. All fixed, all working. Now playing cartridges from anywhere you like. So, another good job done. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next one. Bye.